Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are doing all right tonight. I've just been waiting on the Lord, you know, to release me, making videos. You know, the Lord's been showing me all kinds of things and having me study and research. Sometimes I tell you guys lots of things the Lord tells me. You know, He doesn't release me to tell people as I try to study. But one of the things the Lord just been speaking to me about, I just want to say before I start, I want to pray for you guys, is the Central Arnon Valley. And then the Lord had me to look at that and a precipice. So the Central Arnon Valley, the Lord just spoke that phrase to me. And, you know, you hear lots of river names, you hear lots of things. I wasn't sure if it was in the Bible, but since the Lord spoke it, I assumed it was, and it is. Of course, it's over there just north of Petra in Jordan, and Lord's having me study about that right now, so I just thought I would tell you guys and share that. But I want to come on here and just pray a blessing on you guys, blessing on you, the body of Christ. You know, brothers and sisters, when you're looking at the world, I just want to say this. The reason why I comment regularly about, you know, about all the wacky news and theories that you hear on YouTube, you know, the wacky, or I'll say wacky, you know, people have, everybody has all these theories of trying to calculate the day of the rapture and all that, and calculating the return of the Lord and all this kind of stuff. There's nothing wrong with, you know, of course we're waiting on the Lord, but, and then the news and all the bad news going on and all those things. You know, brothers and sisters, the world is only going to keep getting worse and worse and worse all the way till the Lord returns at the end of the tribulation. You know, and the rapture will happen sometime before the tribulation begins, brothers and sisters, but we don't know how many days, weeks, months, or years that'll be. We don't know how bad things are going to get before the rapture will happen, you know. And so what I'm trying to tell you is let your heart not be troubled. Jesus said, John chapter 14, you believe in God, believe in me also, Jesus said, for in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you so. I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am you may be also. I thank the Lord God Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. And I bless His holy name and His Son's name. Even it says in the song, kiss the Son, lest the Father be angry. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty, through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all ye creatures here below. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Praise His holy name, brothers and sisters. Let me tell you, God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all you can ask or think. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise His name, brothers and sisters. You know, there's a song, haven't heard it in a long time, by Casting Crowns. It's called, I'll Praise You in the Storm. I praise you in the storm. The Lord is with us in the fiery furnace. He is with us in the storms of life. That's why He is Emmanuel. God is with us. Hallelujah. That's the name that Isaiah said is one of the names for the Lord Jesus Christ. He is Emmanuel, God with us. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord with me, brothers and sisters. Just praise the Lord. Hallelujah, Father, we praise you, Father. We praise you, we praise you, we praise you, Father. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You know, the Lord has just put a spirit of peace on me, brothers and sisters, because the Lord has been talking to me. I don't think I mentioned it too much. You know, the Lord has used me many times in the Philippines with deliverance, delivering people from the power of the enemy. You know, when a lost person is lost, the Bible says, Paul said, you know, pray that they might not be blinded anymore by the enemy. So every lost person is blinded to a certain point by the enemy. They may not be demon-possessed, but they have obstacles and hurdles that the enemy puts before them. And now we as Christians, the enemy tries to put hurdles and blocks before us. So, when you think of deliverance, we always think about someone demon-possessed. You know, but there's also people who are oppressed, people who are blocked, people who are frustrated, people who are hindered, everybody. You know, as Paul said, you know, he was trying to go to Rome, but the enemy was blocking him, you know, and the enemy buffeted him. He had a thorn in the flesh. The enemy is buffering him. And Paul said we're not ignorant of his devices. So we have one enemy, you know, the fallen one, you know, Satan and his minions, those powers and principalities and forces of darknesses in high places, you know, the enemies of the kingdom of light, the kingdom of darkness, brothers and sisters. And Jesus said, as long as you're in this world, you will have tribulation. We have persecution. All this comes from the evil one. As Paul said, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against what I already said, powers and principalities, forces of darkness in high places. That's why we need to put on the armor of God, Ephesians chapter 6. That's why when Peter looked, you know, said to Jesus, you know, we've given everything up for you, Lord. What is there for us? And Jesus said, anyone that follows me, you know, takes up their cross and follows me will receive, you know, a hundredfold in this life and in the life to come, houses and vineyards and families and all those things with persecution. With persecution. Brothers and sisters, that persecution comes from the enemy. You know, that's why Paul, through by the Spirit of God, tells us that. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, because God wishes none to perish, but all to come to repentance. So our enemy is not lost people. We could be even ISIS. You know, even though the deeds of ISIS are so wicked and beyond evil like the Assyrians were. You know, think about this, brothers and sisters, and this is, you know, the Lord is just giving me this message like he always does in the middle of what I never thought about this before. It's true. It's even in the same part of the world. Think about this. Some of you know this. Many of you don't. The reason why Jonah refused to go to Nineveh, like in the book of Jonah, everybody knows about Jonah being swallowed by the great fish, the Bible says, and people assume it's a whale, swallowed by a great fish, probably was a whale, because the Assyrians were evil, 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 evil. You read in the Bible, they would poke out the eyes of their enemy and do all these wicked things. They had done lots of wicked persecution, and you know, they ended up carrying the northern kingdoms of Israel. Israel split into two different countries when King Solomon died, Israel and Judah remained until the Babylonian captivity, and then they came back. But the northern kingdoms, what people call the 10 lost tribes, they were scattered all over the known world by the Assyrians, same people that Nineveh was their big city there. So before this all happened, Jonah went there, and he didn't want to go there because they were so wicked and the wicked things they did. Kind of like what ISIS does today, and even in the same region. Never thought about it till just now, so the Lord is leading me. See how awesome is the Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters? I had no idea that I was going to talk about this. I came under to pray for you and praise God. And then the Lord's just putting this, thank the Lord. And I praise God for those of you who watch my videos, because you guys are, you know, like me, you're truth seekers, nugget seekers, and the deep things of God. Praise God in discipleship. So awesome. Praise God. God sends his servants, preachers, to the people who need them, like people that do evangelism. You know, they go to the lost all the time. Anyway, brothers and sisters, even ISIS is the point I was going to make before the Lord just dropped that on me. You know, even ISIS people are, you know, they're under the influence. In America we have, it used to be DWI, now it's DUI, driving while under the influence. It used to be DUI, driving under the influence. Now it's, or whatever, driving while intoxicated, or whatever they call it now. So these people are evil under the influence of Satan, you know. They're living under the influence. So they're wickedness, brothers and sisters. As Paul said, what does the Bible say? It says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against powers, principalities, and forces of darkness in high places. So it's the devil that's inspiring these people. So, you know, it's harder to, even, you know, I'm only human too, but, it, you know, as they say, love the sinner, hate the sin. Very difficult to do in some cases. You know, can you imagine, you know, like following the words of Jesus when he said to turn the other cheek and all that? You're dealing with ISIS and all that? Brothers and sisters, go look at those Coptic Christians, what they did. You know, God gave them that special grace, that anointing to receive the crown of life, that martyr's crown, and had their heads chopped off and drowned and set on fire and all this wicked, wicked, wicked stuff, brothers and sisters. Wicked. I don't know why I'm talking about this. When the Lord let me talk about it, I just want to say this now. You talk about God uses police, the government, God uses him an instrument of his righteousness. Judges, policemen, armies. So the Lord used Babylon, and even though they were wicked, King Nebuchadnezzar was used by God to bring judgment on Judah, and he used the Assyrians to bring judgment on the northern kingdoms. So that's, you know, ultimately God's doing too, brothers and sisters, even at a higher level. Even as we see what Paul, as I mentioned, about the thorn in the flesh, says he prayed three times and asked the Lord to take it from him, and the Lord said, my grace is sufficient for thee, that my strength is made perfect in your weakness, in Paul's weakness. So that's also true, brothers and sisters. Even the ultimate message, higher level than the other message I gave. It's kind of like that second heaven is where the enemy is. And the second level, the first level message is, hey, ISIS wants to kill me. Let's go kill ISIS. Okay, so God ordains governments and armies and leaders to destroy ISIS. And he also could use ISIS to bring his judgment, like he did with the Assyrians in the past, like he did with the Babylonians. That's also true, brothers and sisters. And on that second level, those individuals there are inspired by the devil. They're blinded by the devil. That second heaven, second level spiritual understanding of what's going on. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities and forces of darkness in high places. In the third level, I guess I should title this video, since the Lord gave me this message I had no idea or never even thought about. God is so awesome, brothers and sisters. Those of you watching my videos, almost every video I make, I have no idea what I'm going to say. I came on here to pray with you guys, but now I start mentioning it so people can be at all like I am of how awesome God is. God can inspire you too. And I believe that most people watch my videos. Also, you know, you have that prophetic, you know, gifting and calling in your life too. Are you therefore, you know, as they say, birds of a feather flock together. So you're attracted to that also. So I like to, you know, put that pastoral spin on it, put a teaching moment on it too, brothers and sisters. Praise God. For the Bible says, I believe it's Romans 13, said to prophesy according to your faith, you know. So it's all by faith, brothers and sisters. So so that third level is where God is. As I mentioned, God can use them for judgment. God is ultimately using the devil as his controlled opposition, brothers and sisters, to bring us, some people, to repentance. Some people are brought to repentance when they hear about the love of Christ. Some people are brought to repentance because they're lonely in their life, and you know, they're rejected by their family, etc. They're poor, people have no money, they're in poverty, sickness, disease, and all those different things. They come to the Lord because, you know, they don't have anywhere else to go. Sometimes that's how it is. Some people come to the Lord for so many reasons, but one way, and that's why, you know, we see demons of torment tormenting people who are drug addicts, who are killers, all, you know, and even in the homosexual community, we see all of, you know, people involved in any of these areas of sin, prostitution, whatever it may be. We see a lack of peace in their life, of course, you know, and it's enemy, the demons who are sometimes tormenting them. But the point is, God's purpose is to drive them unto himself, to drive them to repentance, so they do not be comfortable in their sin, brothers and sisters. Because when, you know, when you're living a life in the world, some of you became Christians as young people and even as children, so you don't know what it's like. You know, maybe you've never been a backslider, or you were never a grown person who's not a Christian. Let me tell you something. People are grown people who are not Christians. They don't know that the lights are turned off. They don't know that they are living in torment until they experience, you know, they enter a church, there's an anointed preacher, and then they hear the gospel. Then you go listen to the testimony of people who were drug dealers and mafia and killers and Satanists and all that. Go listen to their testimonies on YouTube. You hear them say, they always say, you know, it's the Spirit of God. You know, they didn't know what it was, but this peace, this love was coming out of the guy who was preaching. A love they had never felt before. A feeling of peace they had never felt before. See, they didn't know they were lacking it until they had the real thing. It's just like someone that had been born in a cave and lived in a cave their whole life and never been outside in the sun. They don't know that they're living in darkness till somebody turns the light on, or they get exposed to the light and they say, wait a minute, there's something better. You know, there is something better than what I'm experiencing here, you know. And it's just like a baby, you know, you give a baby just drinking milk all the time, and then you give them some Pepsi or Coke, you're not supposed to, you know, they're giving some ice cream, and they're like 6 months old or whatever, you let them taste some ice cream. Hey, you know, what's up with that nasty milk? Let me have some of that ice cream, right? Chocolate ice cream, vanilla ice cream, whatever, you know. So They don't know any better, brothers and sisters, until they experience it. Even these ISIS people. You know, if you're in the military or you're in the, you know, and God has called you to be a soldier or a Marine and all that, and then, you know, you're executing God's righteous justice to physically, you know, it's not murder. The real word in Hebrew is thou shalt not murder. You read the law of Moses, you'll see that there's murder. Like I get mad at you and we fight and I kill you, manslaughter, or I waylay and wait. That's where we get the American laws straight out of the Bible. You know, I waylay or wait, lie in wait, as the King James says. I lie in wait to kill you, first degree murder. But as a policeman or in the army, and then, you know, you're doing something illegal and then I'm commanded to kill you as a soldier or a policeman, that's not murder. That is not manslaughter either. That is righteous justice. And God ordains and oversees all that, brothers and sisters. But we who are not military, we're not a policeman and we're not in the military, and we are Christians. Our job is to love our enemies, Jesus said. You know, to heap those coals of fire, Paul said, on their head with our love. We're supposed to pray for those who curse us and falsely accuse us. We're supposed to pray for their salvation, brothers and sisters. Jesus died for ISIS too. I can't believe I'm saying this. It's true. I would have never said this in a video in a million years. Except by the Spirit of the living God. I promise you, brothers and sisters. But it's truth. What I'm telling you is true. It's by the Spirit. It's not by my flesh or my own ideas. But it's just basic biblical doctrine. And I'm just inspired to tell you today, brothers and sisters. Our enemy is those powers and principalities and forces of darkness in high places. You know, the devil is inspiring them. So this is the wisdom of the Lord, what the Lord is telling me to tell you. You know, you want to see ISIS defeated. You don't want to see Christians killed. You know, you have to pray to the Lord of the harvest. You know, we have to take away those minions from the devil. How do we do it? They all get saved. We ask God to intervene. We repent. Even as it says in 2 Chronicles 7:14, when King Solomon was speaking by the Spirit of God with the dedication of the temple in Jerusalem, he said, if my people who are called up by my name, talking about God's people, would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven, I will forgive their sins, and I will heal their land. Now, brothers and sisters, this is the formula that God gave us through the wisest man that ever walked the earth besides Jesus, the wisest human man, full man, that's Solomon, son of David, grandson of Jesse, walked this earth, spoke those words from the Spirit of the living God, the Spirit of wisdom from God. If my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, I would hear from heaven, I would forgive their sins, and I would heal their land. Brothers and sisters, we need to repent. We need to turn from our wicked ways. We need to seek God with all of our hearts. That's what we need to do, brothers and sisters. That's the answer. You know, I wrote in the book, and a sister who edited the book for me, if I can remember correctly, you know, the Lord had given me a text, and it's an obscure text that nobody knows yet. You know, people were surprised. Many people were surprised it was in the Bible. One time, there was a battle, and I can't remember now. I wrote it in the book. It's been 2 or 3 years since I looked it up, but I think it's King Josiah, I think, or Joash. Anyway, you know, they were under attack and all this, and then the Lord told them, put the worshipers in front of the army and let them go out with the harps and pipes and the worshipers walking in front of the army, for the battle is the Lord's, you know, and the king did that, and of course they began to play the harps and worship the Lord going in front of the army of Israel and, or it might have been in Judah. And, you know, the enemy, they all killed each other, or killed themselves. And, you know, many people don't know that text is in the Bible. You know, it's there back there, I don't know if it's in 1st or 2nd Kings or something like that. It doesn't matter. Go Google it if you want to look it up. Anyway, brothers and sisters, because I wasn't prepared to even talk about this, I just want to pray for you, brothers and sisters. And I'm ready for the rapture as much as any of you. Stop looking at the things coming on this world. It's only going to get worse and worse. I mean, you know, the fallen angels are going to show up. The aliens are going to show up, slash their fallen angels. All that stuff. How much will we see before the rapture of all these portals being opened in with the CERN and all, whatever you want to talk about, ISIS, whatever. You know, I could write a list, 100 things that's coming already halfway on this world. America becoming a totalitarian police state, you know, a communist dictatorship, whatever is going there, barring a miracle of God. The internet's going to be totally, you know, internationally regulated through the TPP. We're losing all of our rights and freedoms, but freedom of religion, of course, persecution of Christians. These Muslims are invading all the Western countries, and they're going to start trying to bring Sharia law and beheading people and terrorist attacks. And it's just going to get more and more ugly, brothers and sisters. Barring intervention of the Lord our God. That's what I'm telling you. We need to be raptured, or we need... And but the thing, I want to say this. You know, everybody's wanting to rapture. But let's look at the other option. God will intervene and delay this thing. And delay the tribulation. So that more can be saved. You know, I'm just thinking because I've heard people say, people make a video, I've seen the comments, somebody makes a video and say, hey, let's pray that the rapture happen now. As a matter of fact, it was Brother Gary. People started commenting, oh, that's selfish to want to be raptured. I made a video saying, let's pray that the rapture will be delayed so more people get saved. And then people are saying I was selfish for saying that. I do not entertain people pray as the Lord leads them. I want the rapture to be today. But on the other hand, if the Lord wants to make it 20 years from now and he wants to give America and the world and, you know, and destroy this ISIS and all these evil things and bring a new period of another great awakening, I'm all for that too. Even though I've been inspired by the Lord to say that there is not going to be another great awakening. Still can pray for it. Doesn't matter. You know, God is the only one on the throne. None of us are, no matter what you've heard anybody say, including myself. Doesn't matter. God is on the throne, brothers and sisters. Outside the Word of God and the Spirit of God, nothing else equals the Word of God or the Spirit of God, brothers and sisters. So anything I've said, anybody else says, don't take it as equal to the Word of God, brothers and sisters. Don't take it as equal to the Word of God, the written Bible. Even though I've had lots of sure words and dreams and gave people words of wisdom, words of knowledge that were true and came to pass and or were true and all that, doesn't matter. No man is perfect. Only the Word of God, the Bible, the canon of Scripture we have, and God Himself, of course, the Lord Himself. Brothers and sisters, I want to pray for you. Let's pray. I don't want to get into all this theology. Who cares? Let's worship the Lord. Let's praise His holy name, okay? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we give You the praise. We give You the glory, hallelujah. Yeah, let's praise Him. Yes, let the earth hear His voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice, rejoice. Come to the Father through Jesus the Son, hallelujah. Hallelujah, and give Him the glory. Give Him the glory. Great things He has done. Hallelujah. Glory to the Father. Hallelujah. Father, we glorify the holy name in this place. Hallelujah, Father. Hallelujah. 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 Bless You, Father. Hallelujah. O King of righteousness. Hallelujah, Lord God. You are the Deliverer. You are the King of kings and the Lord of lords, Lord. Father, for You have vanquished the destroyer, Lord God, with the brightness of Your appearing in the word of Your mouth, Lord Jesus. You place the enemy under Your foot, hallelujah, and make Your enemies Your footstool. For You are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Lord, You rule and reign, hallelujah. You rule and reign, Lord, forevermore. Forevermore, Lord Jesus, You rule and reign, hallelujah. Forevermore, Jesus is the Lord. Hallelujah. The Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah. The Son of the Most High God. Hallelujah. Blessed be His holy name. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of His throne. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we praise You. We praise You, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Right now, brothers and sisters, I speak the blessings of the Most High God upon you. Of health, wealth, wisdom, peace, joy, and love. Right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Even as the word of God says, comfort, comfort my people. Hallelujah. And I speak it right now. And the Lord is saying, He's comforting you right now in Jesus' name. I release that spirit of comfort and I speak that spirit of comfort upon the people of the Most High God. Hallelujah. The bride of Christ, the children of the living God. Hallelujah. Who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all you can ask or think. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord God, creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. And blessed be His mighty, holy Son, Yeshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord, our rock, our deliverer, our salvation. Hallelujah. He is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. He is worthy of all praise and glory. Righteous and holy and just are His ways. Hallelujah. For He is a redeemer of mankind. Hallelujah. And I speak right now that He set His seal upon you. Hallelujah. That the seal of the living God be upon you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice. Rejoice, for you have been translated from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of His dear Son. Rejoice in the Lord always. Hallelujah. For you've been redeemed from out of mankind. You've been redeemed from this world. You've been redeemed from the curse of the law. You've been redeemed, hallelujah, by the blood of the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Yeshua HaMashiach. Righteous is His name. Glorious is His name. Hallelujah. The fairest of 10,000. The balm of Gilead. The rose of Sharon. The lily of the valley. The bright and morning star. Hallelujah. The root and offspring of David. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. We praise you, Father, for your glorious appearing, Lord God. For, Lord, we know that you yourself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. And those of us who are alive and remain shall be called up together to meet you in the air, Lord Jesus. So shall we forever be with you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And even as the next verse says, therefore, wherefore, comfort one another with these words. And so the Lord says, be comforted. Be comforted. Hallelujah. For we shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. Hallelujah. Praise God. We'll take off this corruptible body and put on incorruption. Hallelujah. Never, never, never to taste death. For the prophecy will come to pass. It says, O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? Hallelujah. For the grave has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise you, Lord, for you thought it was not robbery to be equal with God. Hallelujah, but made yourself in the image of a man and humbled yourself even unto the cross. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. Blessed be your holy name. You know, the Lord was speaking to me while I was saying that about something else. You know, the Lord gave authority to His servants, to men of God, as they say. Ephesians 4:11, the Lord gave authority to people in the offices of the ministry. And He said to His disciples, He said, I give you power to open doors that no man can shut and shut doors that no man can open. I give you the keys to the kingdom. And brothers and sisters, there are denominational people who don't believe that men of God, preachers, servants of God, do not have the authority to speak blessings on people and all of those things, and even curses, to rebuke and exhort and all those things that it says there. In 1 Timothy, that the ministers of the gospel have the authority to rebuke, to exhort, and to, you know, ensure all sound doctrine in season and out of season. Hallelujah. And I surely say to you, in the name of Jesus Christ, the anointed servants of God have authority in His kingdom. Jesus rules through His people, and Jesus does have a hierarchy in His church, brothers and sisters. He has some that He has given gifts, that's what it says. He says He gave gifts to the church. So anybody that's a preacher, is an elder in the church, is a gift from God to the body of Christ. And I thank the Lord. I'm changing messages here. But it was in my mind. You know that there are all the people who are preachers, all the people, even on YouTube or in churches, wherever you go, who are truly ordained and called by God, course, we know there's lots of denominations that people aren't even saved. We know that. All truly saved, born again, blood-bought, spirit-filled, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost, as they say in the original Pentecostal denominations. They used to have a saying what they'd say. Who are called by God into the ministry. These are gifts that God gave to the church. The ministry in that person is a gift from God and has authority in the body of Christ as a representative of the Lord himself. Even though all Christians have authority, but there's authority in the church, brothers and sisters. Most assuredly, the Bible teaches us that. And I've talked about this before, and I just want to throw that disclaimer out there. Of course, there's the Nicolaitans, the hyperversion of that, taking it too far, too extreme in Roman Catholicism. And then anarchy on the other extreme, which is usually what you have on YouTube. You know, and even in congregationalist churches where the church votes in and out the pastor on a regular basis, where it's a pop, you know, you get the tares and they're voting. That's what happened to the Methodist Church. That's when I get a copy of the video, that's what I talked about in the Methodist Church. I talked about it on videos a long time ago. There was a man that was a Methodist preacher for 80 years. Guy lived to be like 100 years old. He wrote a book about what happened to the Methodist Church, how it brought the Great Awakening to America to a dead religion. What happened? They started letting tares vote in the church. People that were not confirmed as saved, who were not confirmed as truly born again, they took over the church. Voted out the preachers who were preaching the blood. Brought in preachers who were tickling with damnable heresies, tickling their ears. Brothers and sisters, the world is full of people to tickle your ears. You know, I always use Joel Osteen. He's an easy one, you know, just throw it out there. Within supposed to be Christianity. Not talking about Christendom. These, you know, of course, when you go to some of these Mormons or Jehovah's Witnesses or whatever, of course, they're not even Christianity. So, brothers and sisters, true men, servants of God, have authority from God, and I praise God for that. There are many mighty men of God, and that's a whole other video, but I need to make a video. But I want to caution you, whenever I mention a true preacher's name, whether we agree with every doctor or not, some of them, they don't believe in the rapture. They don't believe that's in the Bible. There's nothing to do. They can be in error, or we can be in disagreement about a doctrine. Something like that, about is there a pre-tribulation rapture. It's not take a negate from their authority in the body of Christ. I need to make a video about that. Every time I mention a man of God's name, there's people who will start running that person down. And these things ought not be. And I need to come back with a video on that. The Lord's been speaking to me about that this week. And you know, one of the secrets to revival, I made videos about this a long, long time ago. I'm just going to continue as the Lord is leading me. It's Psalm 133. How good and pleasant it, and I did videos about this, how good and pleasant it is when brethren join together in unity. It's even as the oil that ran down Aaron's beard, even to the hem of his garments. You know, and in that, the Lord had given me a great revelation about that text, that Aaron was the high priest. Jesus is our high priest. We're not under the law of Moses. Goodbye, Judaizers. We're not under the law of Moses. Jesus is our high priest, the Bible says. Not anymore. We're not under the Aaronic priesthood. When it says you change covenants, it necessitates a change of priesthood. So we have the order of Melchizedek. Jesus is a priest out of the order of Melchizedek forever. Hebrews mentions it about 3 or 4 or 5 different times. So that oil that Moses anointed Aaron with, that oil that ran down his beard even to the hem of his garment, represents the Holy Spirit. So Jesus is our high priest, and the anointing comes from the head of the church. The Bible says not Peter, not the Pope, Catholics. Jesus is the head of the church. We have one head. That's Jesus. We are all the body of Christ. So the anointing runs down from the high priest, Jesus, down his beard onto his garment. What makes that anointing run down over the whole body? What makes that anointing running down across all over the whole body? Unity. How good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. It is like the oil that runs down. It's the anointing coming from the head of the church, Jesus Christ, even down to the whole body. So unity among the brethren. And one of the deadly sins, and one of those things that God hates, people call the deadly sins, is feet that are quick to spread mischief among the brethren. And that's what I see on YouTube all the time in the comments and all kinds of stuff. I'm still continuing with a whole nother sermon here, brothers and sisters. You know how I am. But because the Lord put this on me to rebuke it. These people that say they're on YouTube because God called them out there to call out pastors and talk bad about whoever they are. No, God didn't call them to do that. God calls us to what? Preach. If they were called by God, God calls us to preach the gospel. To preach the gospel. To preach the gospel. To give the good news. That's what I do. And I'm not the only one. There's others too. So when you give the good news, you know, you give sound doctrine. You know, you don't say, hey, look, here's a phony $1 bill. You know, say, hey, here, look, here is a real $1 bill. This is what a real $1 bill is, and this is what it looks like. No need to look at the phonies. Here's a real one. Learn the real one, and you'll spot a phony. God bless, brothers and sisters. I got to go. God bless.